And a recent survey shows a majority of people are concerned about how much personal data they've shared online. Ben Goodman is here. He's the Vice President of Global Strategy and Innovation at ForgeRock, and you handle software and security. Let's talk about Facebook, because a lot of people thought, oh, this is just a wonderful platform to share my family photos. And now, you know, here we are a decade later, and we find out there's data mining, they're selling information. What did your survey reveal?
Well, so let me talk about who we are and why we did this survey. So ForgeRock's a company that does digital identity. So we, you know, if you think about your physical identity, there are attributes about you, how tall you are, the color of your eyes, the color of your hair. Well, what all these sites have been doing is they've been taking digital attributes about you, but where you go, what you do online. And so ForgeRock manages digital identity and the security around it. And so what our survey showed was that 40% of people don't even recognize what they're sharing online. And that's really important. And I think that's very telling.
So there's also this huge disparity between what people have shared and what they understand now they have shared. Because even when you first log in, your birth date, all the other information that they're asking for, that's being parceled out.
Well, I think that's what's been so jarring to people, right? Is that I think people understood that services were gathering information about them, and they liked the fact that when they go to a website that's a shopping site, it makes recommendations about what to buy.
Sure.
They like the fact that their media site will show them what movies they may like. What they didn't think about the secondary use of that data, how that data could potentially be used beyond their intention. And I think there is an awareness that's now popping up as a result of this, and people recognizing that these services have a capability of doing a lot with your data.
All right. Are Americans more trusting than people in other countries? Because Facebook is a global company. They've got over a billion users.
Yeah, so we did two different surveys, and it was interesting. One that we did said that Americans were more trusting, and one actually showed the inverse. Hmm. I think the interesting fact here is that regardless of where you are globally, now people are going to be much more aware. And as you and I were saying earlier, you know, there's probably a greater awareness now than there ever was. And so if we probably did the survey today, I think we would see even greater shifting sentiment about how people use their data.
How long ago did you do the survey?
We did the, I'm not sure exactly, but definitely before all this news that came out.
All right, so now that we have all this wealth of information about what's being done with our information, what can you do? What can I do to protect my personal information online?
Well, there's a couple of things to think about. First of all, when you share this data, generally speaking, that data is shared forever. So as your life changes, as your relationship status changes, as your political views change, whatever it may be, that share stays in place. And so you have to do these type of privacy checkups, if you will, to go see who you've shared your data with. And that was one of the things Facebook talked today, that they're going to try to make that easier. Another important thing is it's going to be key now for brands and different services that are collecting your data to make privacy dashboards available that give people the tools to do this. And that's something that we've focused on really heavily. And you know, I think the relationship between people and these brands is going to change. And now people will actually gravitate to brands that respect their privacy and give them these levers to pull.
Yeah, and maybe allow you to filter some stuff out so that all your information isn't on there. Last question, since we're running this poll here, what do you think? What percentage of people are likely to delete Facebook based on your survey results?
You know, I can't speak to what people will actually do,
right,
but what I can say is I think people will change their behavior, and I think they'll change the relationships they have with these services over time, because there's just so much more awareness now about what these services are doing with our data.
Right. Ben Goodman, ForgeRock, thanks for coming.
Pleasure.
For flying in. We really appreciate it.
Yeah, thank you. My pleasure. Thanks for having me.
Thank you, Ben.